Your WCBI First Alert AccuWeather Forecast with meteorologist Vanessa Alonzo.
Well, I hope you've been enjoying the quiet weather so far today because, unfortunately, another winter storm is on the way. Winter storm warnings and winter weather advisories remain in effect for all of us here in North Mississippi and West Alabama as we head into the rest of today into our Thursday. As yet again, a second winter storm in 1 week alone is going to bring us more issues on the roadways and for travel plans. Any areas that get freezing rain, especially, could be dealing with some power outages. There is a chance of a little shot of some cooler air, but nowhere near as brutal as it was after the first system on Monday night into Tuesday when we had those below zero wind chills. But regardless, if you get snow, if you get sleet or ice or all modes of winter weather, either way, it is just going to be a mess out there, especially as we head into the afternoon and into the evening hours. Right now in downtown Columbus, our Bank First camera outside the WCBI studios is showing that roads are looking much better compared to where they were 24 hours ago. Still, roads are slick and icy out there, especially on those bridges and overpasses. So if you need to get out there this early afternoon before the winter storm hits, drive with caution and take it easy out there. That is Main Street in downtown Tupelo, Louisville, Mississippi. Overcast skies as clouds are beginning to move in. Same as well in Vernon, Alabama. Right now, our temperatures are showing 35 in West Point, 30 in Starkville, 28 in Columbus, 29 into Tupelo, 28 into Vernon, 30 in both Louisville down into Philadelphia. Carthage is coming in at 33 degrees. So most of us are still at or below freezing. Some of us are already above freezing. So those areas that are above freezing, that is good news for you. For those of you who are still dealing with below freezing temperatures, that still makes the forecast still a little tricky because we're still trying to figure out exactly what this freezing line is going to do when it moves through here. Our live sweeping radar isn't picking much for us, except in the upper levels of our atmosphere in our far northwestern counties and western counties where we're seeing a little bit of some wintry mix and some snow. Haven't gotten any confirmation of it on the ground as of yet. You have to go out to the Delta where areas just west of the Jackson Metro from Vicksburg into Yazoo City, Greenville, they're already getting some sleet, some freezing rain and some snow, which has already caused a mess on roads on I-55. So all that activity is still heading in our direction as all of this snow, sleet, freezing rain is all heading in our area. So buckle up, everybody. Get ready for that second ride of winter weather, especially as we head into the afternoon and into the evening hours. Temperatures in some spots are going to remain steady in the lower 30s, some spots in the mid 30s, and that's going to make all the difference in what type of precipitation you're going to get just in the next few hours. Our latest hour-by-hour forecast is showing some sort of a wintry mix arriving in Kosciuszko, Louisville, Starkville after 2 p.m., Houston, Calhoun City, Grenada, Winona, Coffeyville, most likely some snow. As we advance this into 4 p.m., Macon, Columbus, Vernon, Aberdeen, West Point, you could get some sleet, possible freezing rain mixed in. DeKalb, Philadelphia, Carthage, some sort of a rain with a wintry mix, while Houston, Tupelo, Pontotoc, New Albany, all snow. As we head into 6 p.m., Vernon, Aberdeen, West Point, Starkville, Ackerman, as that freezing line starts moving up a little more north, Columbus, you can probably start getting an all-rain event along with Macon and Louisville and DeKalb. While our northern counties, you're still going to be stuck in with the snow. And that's going to continue at least through midnight. Chief Meteorologist Keith Gibson will be here this evening with the very latest weather information as it comes in. So stay tuned for the latest. At least we have sunshine and 50s on the way as we head into the weekend and next week.